SpaceX submits comprehensive report on Starship's inaugural launch incident, Space Exploration Powerhouse. SpaceX recently delivered a detailed report to the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration, FAA, chronicling the events surrounding the inaugural launch of its groundbreaking Starship vehicle, an endeavor that saw an unexpected turn of events merely 4 minutes after liftoff. Breaking new ground in space travel, SpaceX executed the maiden launch of a fully assembled Starship on April 20th, propelling the colossal rocket craft duo skyward from its Starbase facility located in the expanse of South Texas. The primary objective of this ambitious test flight was to propel the upper stage of the Starship into a partial orbit around Earth, with plans for a controlled splashdown in a designated area of the Pacific Ocean adjacent to Hawaii. However, the meticulously laid plans faced a hiccup as the two stages of the Starship failed to disengage as intended. In response, SpaceX activated a pre-programmed self-destruct command, leading to the vehicle's controlled detonation at a significant altitude above the Gulf of Mexico. The aftermath of this event was not confined to the skies alone, as the launch also inflicted substantial damage to the Starbase launch site infrastructure, creating a crater beneath the orbital launch mount and sending concrete debris cascading across the vicinity. Swiftly, SpaceX initiated a comprehensive investigation into the incident under the watchful purview of the FAA, the regulatory body responsible for issuing launch licenses. The primary objectives of this investigation were twofold: to establish a clear understanding of the factors contributing to the occurrence on April 20th, and to delineate a strategic roadmap for enhancing the likelihood of success in future endeavors. Recently, Elon Musk's pioneering company submitted the findings of this meticulous inquiry, as reported by Payload on August 15th. Nevertheless, this submission should not be misconstrued as a blanket endorsement for Starship's immediate return to flight. SpaceX has presented its conclusive report on the mishap investigation to the FAA for evaluation. This evaluation is an ongoing process. The statement expounded, "Upon endorsement of the final mishap report, SpaceX will be apprised of the corrective measures required. Furthermore, SpaceX will need to incorporate these measures into their licensing framework before obtaining the green light for subsequent launches." Remarkably, SpaceX has already embarked on several remedial actions. For instance, the company has ingeniously installed an intricate water deluge system beneath the orbital launch mount at Starbase. This innovative apparatus, comprising a robust steel plate that propels substantial volumes of water upwards and outwards, recently underwent its inaugural trial on August 6th during a static fire evaluation of the Super Heavy prototype christened as Booster 9. In line with its fervent pursuit of innovation, SpaceX is diligently preparing Booster 9 alongside an upper stage entity referred to as Ship 25 for the upcoming second comprehensive test flight of the Starship. The objectives of this forthcoming mission are akin to those of the pioneering April 20th endeavor. Following the initial flight, Elon Musk expressed his optimism about SpaceX's readiness to undertake another Starship mission within the span of 6 to 8 weeks, a timeline that tantalizingly positions liftoff as imminent. However, prospective challenges of a logistical nature still loom, remaining independent of the remarkable strides made in the technical realm. Continuing the narrative, the FAA continues to scrutinize the comprehensive mishap report. Concurrently, a coalition comprising environmental and indigenous factions is engaged in legal proceedings against the agency. The core assertion in this legal maneuver contends that the potential ecological and societal repercussions of Starship launches in the South Texas domain were not subjected to a sufficiently rigorous evaluation by the FAA.